Hey, PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. And we get a lot of questions on our weekly podcast, The Full Nerd. You can send in your questions to thefullnerd@pcworld.com. And if we don't answer them on the show, maybe we'll answer them here in this kind of little segment thingy. One of the things I want to know for people who are trying to buy Intel systems is it worth it to pay the little extra premium for that little K right next to the part number?
So my general advice is no. Generally, what you get with a K part, one, it's unlocked.
Okay.
So that means you can overclock it,
yeah.
Make it run at higher clock speeds than it's supposed to for people who are just getting into this. That's always a plus, right? More performance. The actual truth is very few people actually ever overclock their K parts. I will say over the years, Intel has said over and over and over again, we're always surprised by the amount of people who buy K parts because the K part has turned into the CPU that everyone wants, has the best reputation, it gets reviewed all the time.
Yeah.
Those are the high performance parts. They can be overclocked. That's all the coolness. Well, you go to the store, you want the exact same thing they're talking about on the forums, on the YouTube.
Yeah.
You buy the K part. That machine never sees any overclocks its entire lifetime. So why pay the $40 to $50 for it, right? So generally, I think you won't miss it. I think you can be fine without it. The other thing is if you buy a K part and you do intend to overclock, you also have to have a motherboard that supports overclocking.
True.
Higher end Intel motherboards, Z series, newer chipsets support it. A lot of the older ones don't support it, lower end. The lower end ones are intentionally nerfed to keep you from overclocking. Probably fair to keep you from blowing the motherboard up too, but they also are locked. So remember, K part also means generally pricier motherboard. In fact, that's probably what the salesperson's gonna talk you into. It's like, well, if you're gonna overclock, you need this. Now you need this big cooler. That's the other thing, K parts don't come with coolers.
True. Yeah.
So if you buy a non-K part, you're going to get the minimum piece of flare Intel cooler. It'll run all day fine. You'll never have a problem with it. Now, I say all that, and I know that most people go, well, what do I get out of K parts?
Yeah.
Well, generally, at the higher end anyway, the i7, i9, well, there's no i9, non-K. Well, there is. You get higher clocks.
Yeah.
So even if you never overclock, you might get 200, maybe 300 higher clock speeds out of it sometimes on turbo. They may also be, you know, quote unquote, better CPUs, who knows? But I will say most people cannot feel 200 to 300 megahertz, right? It'd be pretty tough unless you play the game benchmark to see the difference. So I think, again, it's fine to go with the non-K part.
Interesting.
Yeah, but again, this all does come back to, I say this, and then you will go to the store and you will talk yourself into the K part because you go in 5 years.
Wouldn't you rather have? Yeah, maybe you want that option.
Maybe I want to, you know, put a custom water loop in there and overclock it. So a lot of people, you know, you're sold on the performance. Nobody likes to intentionally wall themselves off from potential performance upgrades.
Yeah.
So maybe that $50 is worth it, and it's more than 50 because you got to buy a heatsink too.
And the motherboard might be cheaper.
You might feel better.
Yeah.
I mean, that's honestly what a lot of people who buy K parts are. It's just performance. It's just performance.
Interesting.
Because it looks better.
Okay. So. Well, which scenario would you rather do? Would you rather buy the non K part, save a little money on the processor, save a little money on the motherboard, and upgrade sooner, or get that K part? And then later down the road, overclock it to get yourself that little extra boost.
Boy, that's a tough one. If you're being very, very pragmatic, very, very practical, you're going to go for save money now, put it into other components, get you more in the longer run. But your friend shows up, they got a brand new 9900K. You only have a 9900. He or she's got 200 to 300 more megahertz than you. That some people, that's really going to burn them, especially if your friend is kind of going to rub it in your face. Wow, you don't have the K part? I have the K part. So, yes, if you want to avoid those situations, which is real, that is a real situation, that is not even made up, then yes, it's worth it.
Yeah.
And they are, the K parts also are higher performing parts. If you're going to overclock them a little bit, if you even do the auto overclock by turning MCE on, you can get a little more performance out of it. I would argue for the average person, you won't see it, But some people who like to run the drag strip, they like to run the quarter mile, they like to run those benchmarks, then yes, it is worth it.
Okay, well, I want to hear from those non-K users out there. Please chime in the comments. I know we got plenty of the K users out there, so I'm excited to hear from you. Tell us why you went the non-K and maybe how much money you actually ended up saving. And if you have a question, like I said, you can email it into thefullnerd@pcworld.com. If we don't answer it on the show, maybe we'll answer it in a little segment like this. So thanks for taking the time to answer the questions, Gordon, and we will see you later.